Please welcome Vice President Training and Certification, AWS, Maureen Lonergan.
Last year, I found myself in the most unlikely of places, in mile 6 of my first trail half marathon. During the pandemic, I had decided to take up running, and there I was at the top of the trail, looking at 3 peaks and 7 more miles to go. I looked and thought, the car's just a mile away, and I can go back. But I thought about the 3 things that I had done to prepare for this half marathon. The first was the training, the hundreds of miles of training that I had done along my journey. The second was the tools that I used to train. For me, it was my smartwatch, tracking every mile, my pace, and playing my music list, which for me is AC/DC. It's what gets me going. And the community of supporters that had gotten me to that location, the 2 people I train with every single morning, and then the community on the trail. My name's Maureen Lonergan. I'm the VP of Training and Certification at AWS, and whether you realize it or not, we're all in a race to innovate. We all want to be the first to deliver on behalf of our customers. The pandemic has been an accelerant, but it's also been the perfect storm. So whether you were in the middle of a digital transformation and had to move faster, or you hadn't started and you are now in a position where you were having to move fast, it made builders and leaders alike think, do I have the training, the tools, and the community to move to the cloud? Today we're going to talk about the trends that we're seeing with our customers today, and how they're reinventing the way learning looks for their organizations. We're going to introduce some new tools and new experiential learning that we're working on to make it a more engaging experience for you. And we're really going to focus on communities, building communities, because we feel that this is a really powerful way to continue lifelong learning. And then we'll wrap it all up on how those things help in learning and attracting and retaining talent. So if you're ready, let's go. I think the first thing that we have to acknowledge, The first thing we have to do is acknowledge that the rules have changed in the race. Sped up trends around customers' expectations, workforce needs, and how we think about training. Being expected to hit your personal record while the ground's still moving beneath you. The first trend that we're seeing with our customers is that customers expect innovation. Speed, convenience, meeting their expectations requires everyone to be nimble, adaptable, and resilient. So we have to pivot quickly and adjust to whatever unexpected circumstances we found ourselves in, much like the pandemic. Take, for instance, Globe Telecom. Globe Telecom is a full-service telecommunications company in the Philippines. Prior to the pandemic, they had really invested in building out a large-scale training program for their organization. In the Philippines, prior to the pandemic, most people paid their bills at a payment center, which, as you can imagine, took a really long time. And it took time out of the day, the lines were long, and when the pandemic hit, it just became downright dangerous. So with that, Globe extended their micropayment service GCash app to their audience, and they saw that technology get adopted at a really rapid rate. And because of the training that they had, they were able to scale the business and support all of their customers. Now, 2/3 of the people in the Philippines, the customers and individuals, use GCash app to pay their bills. The thing about innovation is, as quickly as it happens, it becomes the new normal. And companies still need to continue to innovate on behalf of their customers. For any company looking to innovate, the greatest asset is always going to be their people. The second trend that we're seeing in the pandemic is the skills gap. The skills gap was tremendous before the pandemic, and now more than 1.8 million jobs will go unfilled this year. Add to that that there is an increase, 4.5% increase, in tech resignations in the market. Scholars are calling this the Great Resignation. Employees are reevaluating what they want from work, from their life, and what organizations they want to work for. This is especially true with tech. They want to build and innovate. I'm sure many of you in this room, like I am, are feeling the effects of this. How you're hiring, shifting workloads, stepping in to fill out the gaps. The third trend we're seeing is a shift in how organizations value training, empower their people, and that can't happen through hiring alone. Companies need to invest and create a culture of continuous learning. Ultimately, each of us wants to do super interesting work. And when you invest in your people's learning and experiences, they're empowered to innovate. You want to create an environment that attracts and retains talents, and we can help you do that. Consider Principal Financial Group. It's a global financial services company with they've been in business for over 140 years. They have a rich history and a long-standing infrastructure, heavily regulated, and you would expect it's hard to innovate. But working with us, that's actually what they did. They reinvented their cloud builder learning experience, transformed their business and culture. And so what I'd like to do is invite Principal Senior Vice President and Chief Information Officer Kathy Kay to the audience to talk to you about that.
Nice job. Thanks for the introduction, Maureen, and for the opportunity to speak. Boy, it's nice to see people for a change. I am proud to lead a team of 3,000 employees at a time of transformation in our company, in our industry, and in the tech sector overall. At Principal, we have 18,000 employees who are passionate about making financial security a reality for people and businesses around the world. We help 49 million customers plan, insure, invest, and retire every day. We help them navigate through uncertain times, and we're focused on improving long-term wealth and well-being. We have a history of reinvention at Principal. In fact, we've gone into new markets, we've exited markets, we've started new products, services, all in response to our customers' needs. So we're used to doing this. But as technology has advanced, customer expectations have changed, and so we knew we needed to be more tech-forward and data-driven. We have insurtechs and fintechs knocking on the door who can move much quicker, who don't have tech debt like we do, and there's always the risk of an external threat that just disrupts the industry. So we knew we needed to make these changes, and we knew we needed to move to cloud, but it's not that easy. We have legacy systems that aren't well integrated, they're not easy to connect to externally, and so we really needed to do something different. Even in the pandemic, it only accelerated that need because we couldn't meet with our customers face-to-face anymore, and we really had to get digital solutions out quickly to meet their needs. And so we really needed to understand what we needed to do to move to cloud, and we knew we couldn't just staff up, that the best option for us was to reskill our team, but provide ways to do that quickly. And so we teamed up with AWS and the TNC team to really help understand what we needed to do to really make this a reality. We're a complex organization. We're in a lot of different businesses. We have many different customers globally. And we knew we needed to get to common language. We knew we needed to get to common metrics. And so we needed to do something different than what we've done in the past in how we've been working. So we started with the TNC team, and they did a little bit of analysis, and they uncovered some challenges that we had. Our current team lacked a lot of knowledge about moving to the cloud, about the benefits of cloud and DevOps. And so we really did a learning needs analysis with them to set a baseline, to really identify the gaps we have, to identify the pace that we really needed to upskill our people, and at the pace we needed to so that we could really enable the strategies to meet the needs of our customers. And we started with instructor-led training, which was well adopted. We really enjoyed it. People could do it on demand. But we knew that we needed more, and we wanted more. And so we started Principal Cloud Accelerate. This was a program that helped us move to cloud within our culture. We teamed again with the AWS TNC team. We leveraged the Skills Guild from AWS to provide a framework for really moving our whole plan together forward. We created a culture of cloud learning. We have cloud advocates who hone their skills on their time, at their pace, who could help each other across the globe. And what's really fun about all of this is it's really removing barriers that we used to have in the past. We used to be siloed, we used to work a little bit independently, and now you see the teams really working together. They have a lot of excitement. We host demos, we do office hours, we do employee trainings and testing, again, on their time, getting certifications. We do lunch and learns, immersion days, and even code jams, which are like hackathons, if you will. The results demonstrated excitement. You can see that we have exceeded all our goals with our sandbox utilization, classroom training, demo attendance. We've had 1,500 participants around the world who had taken some form of training, and that's all across the globe, US, Chile, Malaysia, India, and they're doing it in their language, in their time zone, which is really differentiating and why we partnered, one of the many reasons we partnered with AWS. We also have a cloud catapult team that provides coaching to teams to help move workloads to the cloud. And with AWS and the TNC team, the Skills Guild framework, we have had unprecedented global collaboration across the teams in ways that we haven't seen in the past, and it's really driving business momentum. By accelerating to the cloud, we are seeing results that we haven't seen in the past at the pace we're seeing. Some examples are during the CARES Act, when that first came to be at the early onset of the pandemic, we had small business customers who were very confused on how to apply for funding. And so we had a team who built a quick microsite with just in a couple days to provide all the things that our business customers needed to apply for funding through the CARES Act. That would have taken us a lot longer in the past. We had interns who learned about AWS skills during a hackathon, and they were able to move on-prem data into a cloud data warehouse in 6 weeks. 9 weeks, maybe. In the past, it would have taken about 6 months for one of our teams to do. And then our enterprise cloud team has built 41 reusable services in just 2 quarters. And this is code, documentation, patterns that can be leveraged globally that resides in our Principal Cloud Accelerate Knowledge Hub. Again, the amount of collaboration and actually innovation, because they could fire up these environments so quickly, they can try things, you really unleash them, teams, and it is amazing some of the things that they're achieving. It's also enabled our businesses to work differently. By leveraging some of the AWS services like SageMaker, we've built predictive models in our retirement business that allows decisions to be made at a much quicker pace and with automation in ways that we couldn't do in the past. We've leveraged SageMaker for natural language processing in our insurance business to provide surveys and have provided real-time webhook pipelines for quotes. We've also been able to integrate to a dental claim SaaS provider very quickly. Again, it's something we wouldn't have been able to achieve in the past. When we bought the Wells Fargo retirement business and we had to process all of the new data coming in, it was taking 8 hours on-prem in our legacy environment. We had a team that moved that workload to the cloud. It's at twice the volume now, and it processes in 3 hours. When we want to move into emerging markets or quick new business, like participating in an e-wallet platform with Ant Financial in China, as an example, we've been able to integrate very quickly, again, at a pace we wouldn't have been able to in the past. All of these support our customers in ways that we wouldn't have been able to in the past. Our teams are really excited about this. We'll continue our journey in 2022. We'll continue to do certifications. We'll raise the bar. We'll add experiential training. I know our teams are really excited. In fact, we have a watch party going on back in Des Moines. I have a team sitting up front that I'm super proud of. So shout out to my team. Thank you for all you do. I'm proud to be a part of it. We are very intentional about investing in our people. It's my most important asset as a CIO. It's important that you give them the tools, the time to learn, invest in them, and you will be amazed, give them the time to fail even, innovate, you'll be amazed at the outcomes you can achieve. Training, tools, and community fuel innovation, and I am so excited and proud of the things we've been able to accomplish. I really appreciate the partnership with AWS. I look forward to continuing to work with them and watching what else we accomplish. So thank you. Enjoy the rest of the conference, and I'll turn it back to Maureen.
Thanks, Kathy. That was an amazing story. They've been such a fun customer to work with, and it's been fun to watch them innovate. And it's a testament to what's possible with a deep commitment to learning and a well-thought-out training strategy. Now, I'm probably biased, but I would say that training is the most important part of a digital transformation. Whatever your cloud goals are, you won't get far without the right training. I think that the right training gives you a competitive edge. In fact, 97% of organizations report that training and certification leads to a competitive advantage in their market. Teams are better innovators, report improved security, have seen an increase in productivity. Learning has a major impact on your people, on your products, and on your operation. And the investment will pay off for your bottom line as well. Faster productivity to new hires, higher revenue dollars per new employee, and improvements in delivering cloud projects on time. So you have to ask yourself, is the skills gap holding you back and keeping you not keeping up with the competition, or are you not even crossing the starting line? If so, the first thing that you need to do is find a vocal executive sponsor. This is part of a really important training strategy, someone that is at the highest level of the company, that is understands the business objectives for the organization, is working with the teams to build out a training strategy. They communicate the vision and they get buy-in from leadership and then push that information down into the organization. They set clear goals and direction and expectations, and everyone's on the same page working towards the same objectives. With your sponsor in place, we can start thinking about the team. The people you have today are the people you need tomorrow. You hired them, they know your culture, they know your business objectives, they understand the business, and they're ideally suited to take on whatever challenge. We emphasize reskilling for technical employees, but we also really encourage training across the business. This would be your marketing teams, your finance teams, senior leadership, and more. This is what we call cloud fluency. Everyone speaks the same languages, understands the goals and objectives. They drive richer conversations, have more diverse conversations around how to get to the objective, and it allows companies to embrace agility and experimentation without spending a lot of time and money. Kathy just talked about what breaking down silos and how that enabled, the training enabled them to do that and move much more rapidly than they had in the past. I'd like to talk about another customer, Choice Hotels. They have 7,000 properties in 40 countries and territories across the globe. They were hit especially hard by the pandemic and wanted to, as it did most of the travel industry, quite frankly, and wanted to gain efficiencies and keep low costs low until they knew what was happening. They had a very senior staff, tech staff, 10 to 20 years, but more traditional IT. And they were, you know, nervous. Less than 3 months after training 400 people, over 90% of that team was working in the cloud. And the result was significant for them. They saw an increase in both their shopping and booking traffic while keeping AWS costs low, which was one of their imperatives during the pandemic. Here's an observation from Choice CIOs. His point's an excellent one. Cloud training saves you time and money, but it's not just a one and done thing. The results were amazing, in part because of the training, but really because the tech staff was willing to transform and learn about the cloud. My training as a runner, there are two things that I've learned. The first one is I have to mix it up. I can't train, run all the time. So I do that, Pilates, I swim, I bike, I do different things. I think that helps me to keep agile and moving all the time. The second is staying on top of your game, not stopping or slowing down. Both of these lessons are super important. Gone are the days when technology is releasing every year, every 2 years. You have to create a constant learning environment. We are constantly innovating on our technology, and as such, my team in training is constantly innovating in how we build instructor-led training or digital training. And our core offerings are digital, instructor-led. We do that both virtually and in person. AWS certifications to validate your skills, and we have a large set of education programs. We approach training by building a curriculum plan that fits the needs of your organization. It's not a one-size-fits-all. As we partner with you, we're seeing a pattern that works, and we mix with the right set of training and tools for your organization that map to your business objectives. So I want to talk a little bit about the newest tools we're delivering. For me, I rely on my smartwatch for my data and keeping pace and getting better at that. But different things work for different people. But I think we can all agree that the right tools help anyone. Just like a fitness app, you need a tool that can tell you the strengths and weaknesses of where you are. That's why we offer a free training needs analysis. Learning needs analysis tool. We come into an organization and we sit down with the leadership team and we look at what the skill sets are, what your business objectives are, and how, and build out a plan that meets the needs of your audience. And every learner is different and they like to learn differently. So we take that into consideration as well. It takes data to direct training investments where you need it most. And so we focus on that, we take that data, we build a plan. We also want to only train individuals when they need to be trained. We tie it to projects. We make sure if you are architecting something that the architecture training comes in at the right time. And to get the most from your training, you want to learn AWS from AWS. We're tightly connected with the engineering organization. We have a large learning products team that is focused on building training as we iterate on services every single day. We also have expert trainers that provide personalized training plans. They work with companies to figure out what they're doing, and we deliver training that meets their needs. And our trainers are super curious and interested and passionate about solving the problems of your organization. We talked a little earlier about mixing it up, and what more learners want to see is on-demand and digital content. So to share the newest tools in our training box, please welcome Scott Barneson, Director of Learning Products from AWS Training.
It is good to be back at reInvent in person. It's been a long, difficult, challenging 21 plus months for everybody. And it looks like we may have a ways to go before we get to something that looks like normal. But if you look around, there are some bright spots of opportunity. For those who are interested, who are motivated, who are curious and inspired to build new skills, there's never been a better time to learn. To learn the skills that'll help you move your career forward, help you and your teams meet your targets, your objectives, build value for customers, to build the future on the AWS Cloud. Now, Maureen mentioned the demand for cloud skills is large and it's growing. As a result, the demand for high-quality learning experiences has dramatically increased over the past few years. And at Amazon, we're peculiar in how we build our products. We like to start with the customer and work backwards. And as we've been out listening to the needs of our learners, hearing the requirements of customers, we recognized we have some work to do. We needed to make substantial investments to meet learners where they are, to deliver learning experiences that are relevant regardless of your background, across industries, across geographies, and across learning preferences. Well, I get a few minutes with you all today to share some details on just a few of those investments. First, as individuals and organizations all around the world identify opportunities to innovate on behalf of customers, we've heard loud and clear that having training in local languages is a true difference maker in building broad cloud fluency. As a result, we've increased our investment in localized learning by an order of magnitude. You can now learn in 16 languages across hundreds of courses. We're adding more every week. And for AWS certification, you can now sit for an exam in 10 languages, making it easier than ever to validate your skills with an AWS certification. Now, I mentioned working back from customers. And many of our customers, they crave that instructor-led, classroom-based training. They love the opportunity to sit with peers, to interact with an instructor, diving deep into a subject and balancing the time they spend with their teams. But more and more of our customers are asking us for self-paced digital training, simply because it allows them to fit learning in when most convenient to them. Well, as a result, we launched a new digital learning destination, AWS Skill Builder. Skill Builder brings together a collection of experiences designed to meet the needs of builders of all backgrounds and all levels of experience. You'll find our catalog of 500 plus self-paced digital courses, now with a more intuitive user experience, along with role-based and solution-centric learning plans that allow you to direct your energy to build the skills you need to be successful. We've also launched AWS certification official practice question sets. These are 20 sample questions for all 11 AWS certification exams that provide instant feedback on your responses to help you identify areas of opportunity and bolster your skills. Practice question sets are available now on Skill Builder at no cost and in 10 languages. Speaking of AWS certifications, customers continue to look to AWS certifications to advance their career or simply to build confidence in building on the cloud. And we continue to work hard to improve our program every day. For example, earlier this year, we launched a new experience for the AWS Certified SysOps Administrator Associate Exam, which now include exam labs, which allow candidates to demonstrate their competency by building solutions using the AWS Management Console and the AWS command line interface as part of the exam. We've also launched SAP on AWS, Specialty Beta Exam, which provides customers and partners with an opportunity to demonstrate the knowledge and skills required to build and operate mission-critical SAP environments on AWS. It's a fast-growing, super exciting part of our business. I'm excited to make that our 12th certification when we GA next year. Now, for those in Las Vegas this week, if you've been thinking about getting certified, this is a phenomenal opportunity to prepare for and sit for an exam. We have on-site testing all week, and in the past, you needed to schedule time for a specific exam at a specific time. This year, any exam at any time. So show up and showcase your skills. If you're already certified, congratulations, it's time to celebrate. Come by the certification lounge, grab a snack and a drink, meet with other builders, see what they're up to, or just take a quick break from the show. And on Thursday night, do not miss the certification reception. We'll be at the Brooklyn Bowl. I'll be there along with a surprise special guest. He's a bit of a cloud celebrity, so make sure you're there and join in the fun. All right, I don't mean to brag, but I have a pretty cool job. And one of my favorite parts of the job is getting out and talking to customers. And one of the most consistent pieces of feedback I hear is, Scott, we need more ways to get hands-on practice with AWS services. And the reason for that is customers understand that to convert knowledge into skill requires practice. That's why we're excited this week at reInvent to provide access to AWS Builder Labs. Builder Labs provides a controlled environment where you and your teams can increase your rate of experimentation. Try a new service, build a new solution, break something on purpose without any fear of risk to your production applications. And as you increase your rate of experimentation, you're going to increase your rate of innovation. This is a critical area of investment for us. We hear loud and clear we need to do more. So please try out AWS Builder Labs, keep the feedback coming, and watch this space for more. All right, speaking of hands-on experience, customers not only want hands-on experience for individuals, but they want hands-on experience for their teams. Real-world situations, like building a solution collaboratively or troubleshooting an operational challenge. In response, we built AWS Jam. Jams are team-based, gamified challenges covering common AWS use cases and operational tasks. Where hands-on labs are focused on the individual, jams bring teams together to solve 140-plus challenges built by experts that teach best practices around security, migration, DevOps, AI, machine learning, and more. Today, jams are offered as facilitated standalone events, or in combination with some of our instructor-led courses, where the challenges are mapped to the curriculum. We're also running jams this week at the show, so if you're in Vegas, make sure to join a session and see what it's all about, or stop by the Jam Lounge. I'm sure they'd be happy to share more. So far, customers tell us they love this new interactive format, so you can expect us to continue investing in both the catalog of challenges as well as the experience. All right, we've talked about a bunch of different ways to learn. Instructor-led, self-paced digital, hands-on labs, and jams. And we're working on even more ways to learn. And that's because not all learners want the same experience. And some learners, especially those looking for comprehensive, role-based training, they want something more immersive. And coming soon, I'm so excited to share a preview of AWS CloudQuest. CloudQuest is a role-based learning game that teaches and develops practical AWS skills through learning activities, collaborative challenges, and hands-on practice using AWS services. Players enter a virtual city and choose a skill path like cloud practitioner, solution architect, or serverless developer, and follow a series of quests tailored to the chosen role. As players progress through the game, they earn rewards and status for completing activities that unlock new areas across the virtual city. This is a totally new way to learn, and we are so excited to get it in the hands of customers very soon. We are genuinely thankful to be part of the learning journey of our customers. Now more than ever, it's important that we find ways to bring people together. AWS Jam and CloudQuest are just a few examples of how training can facilitate human connection as part of the learning process. I'm excited to share just one more example with you, AWS Skill Centers. Skill Centers are physical locations designed to attract, inspire, and educate new learners to pursue their potential in the cloud and help us close the skills gap in the market. We're making these locations easily accessible to the public and at no cost. Our first location's open, it's in Seattle. We'll be adding more locations over the coming months. We hope the skill centers will become a place where builders come together to share ideas, to get inspired and learn. That's it for me. I thank you for your feedback. It really does help us improve our products, and thanks to the teams for all the energy getting these offerings to market. Back to you, Maureen.
So excited about what that team is doing. They really made a lot of progress during the pandemic trying to make experiential learning for our customers. I'd like to thank Scott for giving that presentation. And last piece of the puzzle is really talking about building communities. As much as I love running, it's really hard every morning to get up, especially in Seattle with the rain every morning. So I rely on my community, the runners I run with every morning, to get me out there on the trails. And it's my community that keeps me going. And building a community is a really important piece that takes race and innovation to a new level. I want to talk to you a little bit about our Skills Guild framework. Kathy mentioned it. It's a program that we worked with Principal on. But what it is a structured program that provides training, tools, and helps you get communities and marketing, account-based marketing within the organization. And we use it to train hundreds and oftentimes thousands of people within an organization across technical and business roles. One of the more important components of that is this concept of community. So we already talked about having a vocal executive sponsor. The other part of that is really identifying cloud champions within the organization, people that can hold lunch and learns and hackathons and drive learning experiences right now, probably most likely virtually, but in the future, hopefully together and collaboratively. The next piece of that is really creating a space for learning, allowing people to learn, setting up things that have them learn together. And the last component of it, of a community, we believe is really important, is incentivizing and recognizing the people and their accomplishments. So whether they had a team event, a team virtual event, they received a certification. We've seen companies recognize and reward people in different ways. Sometimes it's a pizza party, sometimes it's t-shirts, but it's a really important component. You want to recognize and celebrate people, their achievements, their experimentation. And when you support this learning culture, it demonstrates that when you hire and develop it the best, and it helps you to attract talent. Investing may seem like a nice thing to do, but you can't afford not to do it. Employees stay where they can build interesting things and learn. 75% of learners said that they wanted to do more on-the-job training for AWS services to be more effective. They're also more likely to be satisfied with their employer and in their role. Training a team helps people feel connected, especially during the pandemic. One of our partners said, our remote workforce was desperate for human interaction and the ability to ask questions. We've seen incredible innovation with our customers that focus on building communities. I've had the luxury of working with a lot of these customers that have these Skills Guild, and it's just a really fun environment for the employees. And while we're talking about communities, Amazon is committed to building cloud skills for the future. In 2020, we announced that we would train 29 million individuals on cloud computing skills for free. We're investing hundreds of millions of dollars to do this. We believe this is one of the most critical things we can do is onboard people that are interested in cloud, and I mean anybody, a barista, a gym trainer, whatever that might be. We want to, Skill Centers is really part of that learner acquisition.
We believe if you have an interest in the cloud, we can train you. And we want to continue to invest and innovate in AWS Skill Builder. We're going to continue AWS Skill Centers. And for more on our broader education initiatives, we want to welcome Kevin Kelly to the stage to talk about our education programs.
Thank you, Maureen. So access to Cloud Builder training is an important design point in how we create education programs at AWS. We're really focused on creating a diverse community of Cloud Builders, because if we have a diverse community of Cloud Builders, we're better equipped to build and deploy applications to meet our customer needs. And our focus on diversity goes beyond just gender and ethnicity. We're really trying to embrace true diversity of thought, experiences, and backgrounds, and pre-existing skill sets from adjacent industries, and retraining them for cloud roles. By removing the barriers that are standing in the way, we can grow a diverse and global community. By being intentional about the programs that we invest in and the audiences that we target, we're able to reach as many learners as we can, whether they're just starting out, whether they're in K through 12, or they're in non-traditional learning environments, or they're returning to work. We're really trying to capture everyone who has an interest in a cloud builder role and helping them build a career there. One of those people we helped was Charlotte Wilkins, and she was part of as Maureen mentioned, there's the great resignation going on, but there's also a lot of people that were impacted by COVID. And Charlotte was one of those that was working in the fast food industry in the UK. And before losing her job related to COVID-19 pandemic, a relative sent her a pointer to an Instagram post about AWS Restart. And fortuitously, she took that post, inquired about the program, and actually joined the program and was assigned a mentor and coach who helped her get through the program. With this surge in demand for cloud IT skill sets, this is an opportunity for us to embrace new workers and bring in fresh entry-level talent. We have lots of different types of programs. Restart is one where we're targeting creating entry-level talent from K through 12 all the way through higher education and non-traditional learners. One of those programs is AWS Get IT. And Get IT is a program that's designed to reach young women and inspire them to pursue careers in tech and make sure that they see themselves in careers in tech. Get IT currently runs in Ireland, Germany, the UK, Israel, Switzerland, Spain, and Singapore. And we have more countries coming this year and the following years. Get IT introduces all of the students in a large assembly environment at a school to careers in tech and IT. The students then can form teams and work on projects that they're passionate about. And we ask that they work on projects that are focused on an issue that they're having at school or the local community that are important to them. Students then participate in an inter-school application design competition where they refine their ideas and concepts and create applications that they can actually build and use with AWS. Along the way, the students are inspired and supported by ambassadors, SMEs, coaches, mentors, role models from the wider IT industry. Both AWS and our customers and partners participate in this program. This year, the winning team in the UK developed an application to manage the recycling and reuse of school uniforms. They wanted to create a more sustainable system that allowed their fellow students to gain access to these recycled uniforms, and they built an application to do that. As a result of winning the competition on that particular theme, they got to meet Amazon retail fashion leadership, as well as Amazon Go, because their idea had an Amazon Go component in it, and they actually got a tour of an Amazon Go store, both the front of the store and the technology in the back of the store, and they got to meet the people that operate and build that technology. Another program we have is AWS Educate. And this provides training for students and learners of all kinds who want to learn about the cloud and explore the cloud with hands-on AWS management console lab experiences. Alfredo Colon, realizing his career options were limited after Hurricane Maria in Puerto Rico, wanted a career change. He had some IT experience, but he wanted to build up his cloud skills. He leveraged AWS Educate to do that, and taking free on-demand training and completed numerous cloud career pathways that we have on AWS Educate. Alfredo actually credits AWS Educate with giving him the information that he needed in a job interview at Universal Studios that he ended up getting. We have hundreds of hours of content on a range of topics on AWS Educate, from Cloud Computing 101 to web development to DeepRacer to machine learning. And students can also explore job opportunities, internships, mentorships via our AWS Educate jobs board. AWS Academy is another program that we have that provides higher education level, college level curriculum and labs to universities, community colleges, vo-tech, polytech colleges all around the world. Today we have 7,689 academic institutions that are Academy members in 111 countries on the planet Earth. Academy courses include topics on things like cloud foundations, developing, architecting, operations, machine learning, data analytics, and most of the courses include hands-on labs activities, and they align to AWS certifications. The goal is for our Academy students to graduate not only with a degree, but also an AWS certification and real-world cloud job skills. Kyung Jin Shim, a professor at Singapore Management University, uses the Academy curriculum in her business analytics tracks to prepare students for jobs at customers like Goldman Sachs, Visa, and Bank of America. AWS Restart, the program that Charlotte went through, is truly a life-changing program for the learners that go through that program. And we're going after learners who are unemployed or underemployed and are looking to make a career change. We've had people as diverse go through the program, cruise ship employees, fitness trainers, stay-at-home parents coming back to work, transitioning people from the military into the civilian workforce. We provide free coursework. We cover the fees for the participants to obtain AWS certifications, so we really make it free to the learner. And the only thing that we ask is the applicants bring excitement, enthusiasm, and a willingness to learn the cloud. We also partner with workforce development programs around the world to place these students. AWS Restart will end this year in over 95 cities in 28 countries, training over 4,000 learners globally. Let's see what Accenture in Australia had to say about AWS Restart.
The AWS Restart training program helped Accenture address a shortage of skills that we were facing.
We were interested in hiring from the AWS Restart program because it is a fantastic source of entry-level talent. The program produces a really high-quality candidate that we were really excited to bring on board.
Before joining Restart program, I was working in a hotel as a guest service officer. After completing AWS Restart program, I have joined Accenture as Senior Consulting Security Analyst.
Before joining AWS Restart program, I was working as Hacking and Compliance Officer in local government. I'm currently working as a System Analyst, and my job is to assist testing and development teams.
At Accenture, we want to help them to further develop that decision that they've made and really help them to grow those skills that they've already learned.
Inclusion and diversity is a business imperative. We want to be a successful and innovative company, and that means that we have to have people who have a wide range of backgrounds and experiences so that we can provide the best solutions to our clients.
We always want our employees to feel at home at Accenture and to really build their careers with us. We see these graduates as our future leaders, and we want these graduates to come in and build their careers and stay with us long term and see a real future with us.
Some amazing stories coming out of the Restart program. One of my favorites is a military member in the UK. He was coming out of the military, and he had been in the military band his entire career. And he retrained for a cloud role and is now a site reliability engineer. We also focus on employment solutions. All of our AWS education programs are designed to inspire young learners and learners closer to the employment threshold to consider all types of career in the cloud, including adjacent careers, and to provide access to these training opportunities at no cost to them so they get what they need in terms of training, including hands-on skills, to land that first cloud role. The mantra, our goal for these programs is smiling face holding a badge. We really are focused on human outcomes, where we want these people to gain employment in our ecosystem and help us build and deploy applications in the cloud. All of our customers and partners can really help here by hiring a mix of experienced and entry-level cloud builders. There are a lot of advantages to doing that. One is you can hire people, right? You can fill some of your open roles with cloud-ready, eager, motivated talent that wants to learn more about your industry and AWS. It also frees your experienced workers to work on higher level tasks. And this turns out to be an important mechanism for retention, because when your experienced tenured workers can focus on the tasks that challenge them, and the entry level employees can focus on the other tasks that are also challenging for them, it creates a really good working environment. It also turns out tenured, experienced employees like to train those coming behind them. And it becomes another interesting retention mechanism by creating a more rewarding environment for your experienced tenured talent and allowing you to provide opportunities that that experienced talent finds rewarding in helping entry-level talent. It can also help you develop expertise in your own onboarding of talent at your company and helping you create that pipeline. And finally, it can give you access to a more diverse workforce and pool of candidates than you might currently be looking at, and provide more stability by giving you a wider mix of talent and employees at the workspace that have different amounts of experience and tenure. In fact, it can help you turn the cloud IT skills gap scarcity into an opportunity with AWS as your training partner by hiring some people from these education programs that we've created. With that, back to you, Maureen. Take us home.
Thanks, Kevin. I actually had a really interesting conversation last night with someone. I was presenting at an ID&E event, a diversity and inclusion event, and a gentleman came up to me after I presented and said that he had been part of the Restart program and that it had transformed his life and showed me pictures of his family. It was so awesome to see. This week, you're gonna learn a lot. This is my 10th year at this event, and I'm super excited to be back in person. This is our biggest learning event of the year. And as you're listening to keynotes or going to tech sessions or taking labs, I'd like you to start to think about the things that we've talked about today and how we can help you in your journey to the cloud. You know, don't forget about the Skill Builder with the 500 free courses that are available to anybody. The second thing is make sure that you go back and find an executive leader champion within your organization that can help to drive this culture of learning within your organization. And lastly, a lot of people may say the best part of the race is the finish line, but for me, it really is the journey and running. It's exciting, it's invigorating, it's empowering. Hope this empowers you in your race to innovate. Thank you so much for coming, and have a great conference.